Nectar is a sugar-rich liquid produced by plants in glands called nectaries, visible as tiny droplets either inside a flower or on other parts of a plant, depending on the species. This sweet viscous secretion is for animals that feed on it what hot chocolate is for us, which makes nectar the primary reason for them visiting the flowers. Pollinators that feed on nectar include insects such as mosquitoes, hoverflies, wasps, bees, butterflies, and moths. Even birds like hummingbirds and honey-eaters, mammals such as bats, etc. It is mainly a watery solution of the sugars, fructose, glucose, and sucrose, but also contains traces of proteins, minerals, acids, and essential oils. Why should we study nectar? Because nearly 75% of all worldwide crops are dependent on animals to achieve efficient pollination. In addition, in US alone, pollinator-dependent crops have been estimated to have an annual value of up to $15 billion, and poor pollinator visitation has been reported to reduce yields of certain species by up to 50%. Nectaries are glandular plant tissue that exudes nectar and can be either structural or non-structural, depending on the level of their differentiation from surrounding tissue and continuity of secretion. They may vary in color, number, and symmetry, which means they can be used in plant taxonomy. Based on their location on a plant, nectaries can be floral or extrafloral. The first ones are located within the blossoms on different parts of the flower close to its sexual organs, so we can find them on sepals, petals, stamens, or carpels, depending on the species. The major role of this type of nectaries and nectar they produce is to attract previously mentioned pollinating animals. Feeding on nectar draws animal visitors into contact with the pollen, which then sticks to their bodies and thus gets ready to be transferred to another flower. Most flowers secrete only relatively small amounts of nectar, which encourages cross-pollination, since animals must visit several flowers in order to receive a full meal. In addition to being the primary reason for pollinators to visit the flower, floral nectaries can also be involved in its defense. For example, in the nectar of tobacco flowers, certain proteins can be secreted to defend a flower from certain pathogens. In particular, an enzyme called nectarin-1, which is a superoxide dismutase, catalyzes the production of high levels of hydrogen peroxide. Hydrogen peroxide is a compound that effectively kills invading microbes and fungi. However, defense from herbivores is the primary role of extrafloral nectaries. They have been described in virtually all above-ground plant parts, including leaves, cotyledons, petioles, fruits, and stems, among others. The nectar on vegetative plant structures can serve to attract animals that are then manipulated into defending the plant. Particularly, some species of wasps and ants are known for deterring, hunting, and killing caterpillars and other herbivores, even mammalian ones, that are destructive to crops which provide nectar. Conversely, many species of carnivorous pitcher plants use nectar in their traps to attract prey to their dens. Nectar is secreted from epidermal cells of the nectaries via either trichomes, which are epidermal outgrowths of various anatomy and size, but are best known as plant hairs, or modified stomata, which are in its classic form microscopic pores found on the epidermis of plants through which plant breeds. Certain nectaries contain both trichomes and stomata. In addition to being directly consumed as food, nectar is also the raw material used by honeybees to produce honey. Sugar content of nectar varies from 3 to 80%, depending upon such factors as plant species and soil and air conditions. However, honeybees rarely gather nectars containing less than 15% of sugars. Carbohydrates, amino acids, and volatiles function to attract some species, whereas alkaloids and polyphenols are produced to repel them. The typical example of this is Nicotiana attenuata plant, whose common name is coyote tobacco, native to the US state of Utah. This plant uses several volatile aromas to attract pollinating birds and moths. The strongest such aroma is benzyl acetone, but the plant also adds bitter nicotine, which is less aromatic, so may not be detected by the bird until after taking a drink. The evolutional purpose of this bitter chemical addition is to discourage the forager after only a sip, motivating it to visit other flowers, therefore maximizing the pollination efficiency gained by the plant for a minimum nectar output. So, the production of nectar as a food reward for animals, in exchange for either protection or help in pollination, is a classic example of coevolution.